Hello, y'all. I'm back. It's an emergency. I didn't even check the time before I see. Look what they're doing. Like, as soon as I pass by, oh, you turn on the ignition. So, it's, oh, and he had one headlight. I'm not crazy, y'all. I can't even see the license plate. They are purping really heavy. It's 1:13 p.m. in the afternoon, and they just had a perp with a black guy with a red shirt and black shorts. So I'm trying to get like sorry for the traffic noise. It's an emergency, and I need to be able to concentrate on what I have to say. So, hold up. Oh, they got some. So many flies and stuff. Is this okay? So yeah, I try to be by my stuff. So I asked for permission. They said it's okay for me to come over here. So to 2024 is, I thought 2023 was bad, but 2024 is, you know, it's not the year, you know, it's the worst, nationally and, personal wise, you know, or worldwide, you know, it's just not the year. So, I am disturbed. And I started to cry a couple of times that I can't believe that my twin sister is, oh, shucks, flies. So, well, oh, it's flies. So my people are coming, people are coming on my YouTube channel and telling me that my twin sister had got arrested I'm just like really scared. Like, I don't even know how I should formulate my words, you know, but so, like, I don't trust anybody who, because of, you know, the gang stalking and everything, I don't trust anyone who's supportive of my twin sister and at the same time, you know, act like as if they're against me, you know, due to the gang stalking. So I didn't even get it on, actually on footage, that white truck. I mean, the white Escalade with one headlight that, when I walked out of the library and he was waiting for me to come out and then turned on the ignition, it's like, wow. So now that I'm talking about my twin sister situation, it's like they're gang stalking me like super hard. You know, so it's like two people came today with so-called new accounts and came and told me about my twin sister going to jail, you know, I didn't even watch the whole live stream video. Not the entire video. But I heard that she had already went to jail or whatever. And, like, even with the other situation that happened, it's like, as I said, I do not know the city and state my twin sister is living in. She makes it a point to make that none of my business. So even if I wanted to, you know, I would be forbidden and not allowed to know her, you know, her address or her whereabouts or what city and state she's in. And so, so I mean, it's like, I heard she already went to jail. It's like, this is insane because, well, I went to jail on the false charges in 2007 with the me writing out, you know, trying to cash a check that I didn't know was from a fake bank or a bank that didn't exist. If I would have known that, then I would not have tried to cash it. You know, I mistakenly thought it was legit. So I recently got arrested and went to jail, you know, a month ago. So a month and 3 days later, here go my twin sister going to jail. If, you know, she's supposed to portrays herself as a violent thug or whatever. But she hadn't been to jail. But it's a shock to me to find out she went to jail. Like, for what? But I mean, Ramona has never been to jail, but she had a warrant out for her arrest when I was living in Denton, Texas, but she was already back in New Orleans, and I didn't know where she was at the time. Ramona had a warrant out for her arrest for stealing, you know, but for actual stealing. But yeah, I mean, I tell y'all just about every day about my recent arrest. You know, basically, the real reason why the officer arrested me for not answering questions. That's what she kept on saying. If you don't answer my questions, I'm going to take you to jail. But as I said, I did not know that it was illegal to stay there because of my experiences in, you know, Pensacola, Florida. And I didn't realize that the laws were different. You know, but I did not have a malicious intent to commit a crime. I didn't do it on purpose or willfully or intentionally. You know, I mistakenly thought it was legal, you know, since the place was vacant and nobody could live there. So, but I witnessed through the video of the aftermath. It seems like my twin sister's cult followers, a lot of them, even the ones that's been gang stalking me, it seems like they, a lot of them had changed their mind about her or turned against her. You know, but it was I can't even speak on what I saw. I'll just say it was like a disturbing domestic violence situation with my twin sister, you know, physically abusing and beating on the new girlfriend. And the last situation where they said that her nose was bleeding and she tried to broke glass and tried to cut herself and stuff. I was begging my twin sister to please get out of that relationship with her. But, you know, so, all I know is, like, I'm horrified about, and I'm horrified and, like, very disturbed about the parts of the video that I saw. And it's like, I didn't even realize, because I had been you know, y'all know my situation. You know, I have not been close with my twin sister due to her gang stalking me. And so while she has a lot of dysfunction and chaos in her life, you know, she tries to falsely paint me as mentally unstable and crazy. So it seems like she got some kind of fame and like thousands of more subscribers off of her dysfunctional relationship, you know, and it's like now they want to try to make me famous in an embarrassing and bad way. And, you know, I don't want to be famous at all, but to be like made famous for an embarrassing reason. Yeah, it's really shameful, but I'll say this though. Some of the online perps that's condemning my twin sister and condemning her for her crimes and making like as if y'all lost respect for my twin sister, y'all are such hypocrites. Because all that bullying, harassing, and threatening me online, unprovoked for no reason, that y'all do, y'all should be locked up and charged too. But y'all think y'all invincible, like y'all would never get caught. But even if you don't suffer on this earth, you will suffer in hell. So my twin sister, like, was physically abusing and beating on the new girlfriend. I would have thought it would be, like, the new girlfriend looks like she seems like she's stronger and tougher than my twin sister. Like, she looked like a rough person, and I heard that she's supposedly from Chicago. So, and then my twin sister bragged about being stronger than her. And so, like, what I went through with my own twin sister in 2017, when I saw the beating what she did to the new girlfriend, I'm like, oh, shit, this could have been me in 2017 with being beat like that. And it's some other disturbing stuff, you know? But it's like, ever since she got with this new girl, it's way more trouble, and I wouldn't even call it drama. But it's like a lot of chaos, you know. I mean, she had her arguments with China or whatever, a few little fights, but this is like a very traumatizing and dangerous situation that what she's in with this person. It's like, I mean, somebody said that my twin sister was, you know, demon possessed. And other people were saying she was drunk in the video, you know? But then this fake aggressive diamonds, aggressive defiance TV perp, you know, is doing a live stream about us, like, right now. And trying to smear campaign. And it's like, first of all, how are you going to say Candy Grand Prix, live stream saying Candy Grand Prix exposed when you barely know any or all of the facts? You just, you know, parrot false rumors about me without investigating for yourself. And, you know, even other malicious perps talking about Candy Grand Prix exposed, you know. So that Jessica Ricketts Holiness gang stalker is hypocritical with condemning my twin sister and making it like she lost all forms of respect for my twin sister about crimes, when Jessica needs to look at her own crimes, at cyber crimes, bullying, harassing, and threats that she did to me. Threatening to come, like when I was in Pensacola, she would make threats at me and talk about coming to Pensacola to bash my head in concrete and pistol with me and all kinds of threats at me. And due to the gang stalking, when the target reports something, cops don't pretend that they can't do anything. But when a perp reports, makes a false report on a target, in which making a false police report, I thought that was a crime. But when a perps make malicious false reports about me, you know, oh, the cops take them seriously with no question and attack and do whatever to the perp. Do whatever to the target. So now they're calling my twin sister crazy. And they're trying to so-called, you know, compare our so-called craziness. You know, but at least I know I'm telling the truth and living the truth. I have no lies or deception here, at least not intentionally. But if I had a misunderstanding about something, I'll be honest that I misunderstood something. But I don't even, nowadays, you know, I don't even lie on my enemies. I do not even lie on my enemies. I did when I was a kid, when I was a child, you know. But nowadays, you know, I wouldn't even lie, intentionally lie on my enemies. So, I mean, I feel like extremely hurt and disturbed, and I don't even know exactly what words to describe how bad I feel about my twin sister going to jail and people trying to say that she got multiple criminal charges. But like when I, you know, was wrongfully arrested from the gang stalking setup and false police calls, my twin sister sided with the cops and rejoiced at my me going to jail, and insulted me and my college degree and said, oh, even I know not to go trespass on private property, whatever. She was talking all kinds of, you know. And then she made a fake community post saying all she had to do was listen. You know. So at 40 years old, I'm finding out that none of my family members have the right to have any authority over me and any kind of control or bossing me around is abuse, you know. So remember I told y'all the foster mom, Adrian Felder, used to physically abuse and beat on us. And the foster brother, Joe, used to physically abuse and beat on us. And the foster brother Joe would physically abuse and beat on him. Not every wife or whatever, but he would physically abuse and beat on the first two wives that I knew he physically abused and beat on. But Joe was not drunk. Like all the time, the beatings that we eyewitnessed and ear witnessed, Joe was never drunk or under the influence or anything, you know. But this is scary that my twin sister is like, get drunk and then have like severe violence like this. And then, you know, she tried to falsely paint me as the crazy and violent one. Now, the biological brother Derek would physically abuse and beat on women, you know. But I don't know about the woman that he's with now, but he was an underage teenager, you know, not even 17 years old yet, and he had an 18-year-old girlfriend. And he physically abused and beat on her. And I heard that she supposedly burned him with an STD. But then he supposedly mentioned about being a dead man walking. But and then the biological brother, Pete, he would get drunk and physically abuse on and beat on his girlfriend, Willie Mae. And so, you know, people kept thinking that my twin sister in the video was a guy. And they had to keep correcting her saying that, I mean, they had to keep correcting each other saying that, no, this is a woman. This is not a dude, you know. But it's like triggered and re-traumatized me all over again. to see my own twin, you know, do her girlfriend the way that, you know, the way that what we eyewitnessed, the way we were treated growing up, and the way the foster brother Joe would treat his wife. I mean, the first and second wife, you know, both the first and second one. But Joe, I heard that he couldn't beat the third wife. You know, he couldn't beat the third wife. But the foster mom, well, she didn't get drunk and beat on us, but she would be sober and physically abuse and beat on us. And we were little kids, you know. I mean, I spoke on throughout the past few years about publicly, you know, speaking about the foster mom's, you know, abuse towards us. You know, so, I mean, my twin sister's cult followers are running to me saying that the new, I mean, it's public, you know, it's public information. It's publicly put out there that the new girlfriend gave her, you know, a disease or whatever. And so, I mean, and so it's like, I mean, I feel really bad about my twin sister going to jail. And I don't know what city and state she's in. And those people, the couple of people with the so-called new accounts that came to, you know, tell me about my twin sister or whatever, I blocked them because they said it from a point and sounded like they were being trying to be messy. You know, seemed like they were trying to just gossip and be messy and instigate and some of the people found it disturbing, and other people, you know, found it entertaining. Only, I guess the sociopaths would find it entertaining, you know. But, yeah, so, like, the last incident where my twin sister got drunk and had the bloody nose or the busted alcohol bottles or whatever was going on, you know, I only watched a couple of small pieces of that video. You know, I didn't even really watch much. And, you know, I haven't even been keeping up with my twin sister. I'm sitting here battling my targeting and what I'm going through, you know. And fighting for my basic survival. And it's, you know, disturbing and frustrating and upsetting that people are falsely accusing me of being a grifter and scam, because my twin sister started those lies after I started speaking out and exposing her as a perp. She even had red shorts in the video. So with her being a perp, is she gonna have like a reduced jail or prison sentence? Or and then come back to gang stalking me even harder? Or is she gonna be put away for a long time? But yeah, Wyatt, back in 2012, 13, something like that, he went to jail for like a domestic violence with a girlfriend. And then Mark went to jail for beating Brandy up, my twin sister up, in 2015, and he bloodied her face and then lied and said she did it herself. You know, but both of them lied, so I don't know who's lying. I wasn't even there. But she fought Wyatt in 2014 and supposedly she told me she pulled a gun out on him, and then kept on switching her story and, you know, switching her story and lie in stages. You know, so, but Ramona tried to, you know, set Sean up to get arrested and go to jail, but thankfully she didn't succeed. This was, I don't remember how many years ago, but in 2006, after Hurricane Katrina, I heard that something about that Sean got arrested for trespassing for not knowing that he was in a forbidden area after Hurricane Katrina, you know. But, and then Sean got arrested in 2018 and went to the same jail I went to. And he got arrested because they had people who, you know, they set him up to lose his temper. And that's what made me question if Sean is targeted or not. If they, that make me question if, because it seemed like as if they, sounds like as if they were perping Sean and manipulated for him to go off. And then the cops were right there and rough handled and, you know, I wasn't there, but he told me what happened. You know, so, but Pete, oh, and so it's like, before then, my twin sister, she had problems with the police also. I guess both of us did after foster care. But then, you know, and it's like, well, maybe it's best that I stay away from all of the family. You know, but I don't even have the guts to call any family members and tell them what happened. And they're so evil that whether what happened to me or what's going on with my twin sister, they wouldn't even care. Or they would laugh it off. You know. So, I mean, you saw how drunk Lady Yvonne treated me at her door. You know, I'm family. And these online strangers think that they got more rights to my twin sister than I do, even though we don't get along because we were programmed and brainwashed from foster care. The foster mom was not supposed to do that to us, manipulate for us to not be close. But I'm my twin sister's family. And y'all think y'all got more, internet strangers think y'all got more rights to her life than I do. Like, they all found out before me what her so-called criminal charges were, or are, or something like that. And I don't have the funds to bail her out. I didn't even have the funds to bail myself out. When I got arrested, you know, at that time, I didn't, you know. But I had been praying for my twin sister to get out of the relationship. You know, she was safer with China, but I don't condone, you know, those kinds of relationships, you know. But... and I did not know that my twin sister was a freaking alcoholic. Well, Drunk Lady Yvonne is an alcoholic, and Pete is an alcoholic, and certain other family members are alcoholics that I'm not even sure, you know. But certain family members are gambling addicts. Ramona and the biological nephew John, they're gambling addicts, you know. But they had some other stuff I was trying to say or that I needed to say. You know, about this situation. But yeah, my twin sister, I mean, and it's like even the fake aggressive defiance perp was sitting there using my videos without my consent or permission, you know, in a fake live stream. And it's like you're doing videos commenting on stuff you know nothing about. You're gossiping like a damn female. And you're supposed to be a dude. Being messy like a damn female. Like, you keep your mouth shut and stay out of our damn business. Even if we do put it on the internet, but it ain't for your business to have the right to you know, to meddle and instigate and be messy and create your own false narrative when you don't know shit about what's going on. But y'all sitting there doing fake videos talking about Candy Grand Prix exposed. And falsely accusing me of pretending to be targeted and scamming people when y'all actually the ones who's stalking and sabotaging and ruining my fucking life. And I've been documenting every moment. I've been documenting too much for y'all to be... But y'all feel threatened at me exposing the truth. So that's why y'all keep on spreading. The more truth I speak, that's the more lies y'all spread. And create more false narratives. And you don't even know the truth or the whole story. And you see the truth and still have a twisted narrative full of lies because the devil is your father. If you knew the real Candy Grand Prix, the real Candy Grand Prix always wanted to be independent and self-sufficient. But this gang stalking, the same one stalking, following, harassing, bullying, threatening me, they're the same ones spreading the lies that I'm a grifter and a scammer. Because y'all forcing me to be homeless, won't even let me have my own job. Won't even let me have my own place to live. Online and in-person gang stalkers. And my twin sister sitting there saying, you know, that I deserve to be hurt out on the streets and telling everybody, don't help me. She's lying to an audience of 5,600 people. Lying to an audience of over 5,500 people about me. And even despite what she's going through, she still loves Tierra more than family. And everybody acting like they're so concerned about the dog Pippa. You know. So last night, I did not feel safe because they had a homeless gang stalker. He had on like a red and black long sleeve shirt. It was a black guy, and he had on gray pants, and he kept on trying to come near me and talk to me when I was off by myself. And then they had these two homeless white guys who were perps, and a lot of their belongings were red. And they tried to pretend to fake like they were asking me what time it is. You know. So yeah, like last night, I mean, it's like, why? I'm by myself minding my business, and they have gang stalking homeless men come up to me and start harassing me and stuff, making me feel unsafe. And y'all falsely accusing me of wanting to be homeless or no. I have a whole bachelor's degree. You know, I'm not insane. But they say that the ones labeled as crazy are the ones that be telling the truth, and you won't listen. I am legitimately being targeted. Even yesterday, the fake Darnell Williams perp tried to harass me and talk about turn to the other side. Or switch sides now. Meaning, sell out. No. My twin sister already sold out. Tierra sold out too. Is her name Tierra or Tiara? I'm not sure how to exactly pronounce her name. But tomorrow is supposed to rain. Tomorrow afternoon, evening, and night is supposed to rain. And like, I have $14 in the bank right now and no cash, and I'm not eating lunch, and that money is just gonna be used towards dinner tonight. And if I have enough left over, bus fare for tomorrow. But you know, other than that, I need help with, or else I'm going to end up getting rained on tomorrow night. And then Wednesday, I get the Social Security check. But all these criminals, just because you're committing crimes online does not mean that you're exempt, that you should be exempt. You know, just because you're committing crimes online does not mean you should be exempt. You know, because y'all, it looks like even the fake Aquarian Doris perp tried to come and bully, harass, and threaten me and cuss me out. And my twin sister fed y'all a false narrative. I mean, I don't even know if this situation caused some of y'all to wake up. Y'all owe me an apology. If you realize that Candy Grand Prix was not lying or crazy after all. You know. But it's a shame that it's mainly black people, my own race of people, who are the most oppressive towards their own kind. You know, but other races of people, they don't really try to tear each other down and call each other, oh, a scammer or whatever. You know, if it's other races of people that say that they're homeless and need help, y'all support and help them. But our own black people, especially black women, y'all falsely accusing us of scamming. I've never been known to be a scammer. Never been known to be a fraud, but y'all have a fake narrative about me. And right when I'm turning the corner, this perp gets out this white car. Y'all have a false narrative about me or whatever, you know? And then she gave me dirty looks. So, but I'm gonna try to go back inside. It's like I'd be afraid and traumatized by violence, you know? But I'm gonna go for now.